Hey, welcome to the fourth part of creating medieval boots. In this part, we're gonna get a high poly into Maya and we're gonna start retopologizing it. So to start off, you wanna have everything merged into a new Z tool, and then we wanna dynamesh everything together. This will make sure that we have no gaps. So once you're happy with your dynamesh, you can decimate it. And this will just lower the poly count of your model. You want to try to get your poly count as low as possible without losing too much detail. Because if the poly count is too high, Maya is gonna be really slow once we retopologize. You want to select your mesh and you want to hit the little magnet on top to make it sticky so we can retopologize it. And we're gonna start really simple by just placing a cube. We're gonna do a smooth mesh preview, just hit the 3 key. We're gonna delete some sides. So now we have a cylinder once we smooth it. So now we're gonna move this cube into place. And we're just gonna try to cover the boot. So we're gonna add some extra segments because you wanna try to keep it even squared. Now we can convert the smooth mesh preview to a smooth mesh and we can see how it looks. Now we can conform the mesh and this will just make it stick to the boot. So now I'm just gonna move the verts around a bit and push them out so we can cover the boot nicely. And at this point, all I'm trying to do is like make a really nice, simple, low poly base. And we're gonna use the multi-cut tool a lot to cut into the low poly and to define the features. So you want to pay attention where you put these polys and you want to have them end at the features. So I'm just going to put in polys and I'm going to cover the whole boot. If you hold down the shift key, you can smooth your topology out. And if you hold down the control key, you can add an extra loop. At this point, we want to try to avoid any triangles if we can, and focus a lot on the poly flow. It's nice to sometimes hide your high poly and just kind of turn around your low poly and have a look how it's looking. We can press the 3 key to smooth it out to see how it will look like once we subdivide it. Because this is a base and we're gonna subdivide it, we're gonna put in more work. So after subdividing, I noticed that I didn't like this area, so I'm just gonna get rid of it for now. So once you're happy with how it's looking, just convert your smooth mesh to actual polys. And now that we have a good base, we can start to refine this base further. You want to pay close attention that the verts are laying on the surface. You can easily pull them out when you use the soft selection. Again, it's important that your topology is lining up with your features, so pay close attention that it's lining up properly. So I'm just gonna go over the whole model and line stuff up with features. Keep paying attention that the verts are laying on the surface and not beneath it. And as you can see, just like when I'm sculpting, I'm going over the whole model, not one area at a time. Keep working on the whole thing. At this point, I'm merging the topology of the pants together with the boots. This will just make animation, mip mapping, and a whole bunch of other things easier. So here I'm adding an extra loop, and this is just to keep the shading looking nice. You want to keep an eye on the shading all the time, so just smooth mesh it and see how it's looking. So now we're getting to the worst part of retopology. That's the things like cutting in these straps. It's a pain, but it's important to keep them all merged together, because this will just be easy on skinning, animation, mip mapping, LEDs. So it's good practice to keep it all merged together, not have separate objects. The biggest issue this will deliver is clipping issues with the animation. And if you have everything merged together, you cannot have clipping, which is nice. So again, keep an eye on the shading. I'm just gonna make this edge hard. I'm gonna see how it's looking. Thank you. So now I'm gonna repeat the process I did for the one strap for the other straps. You want to have a vertex at a little indent, because we can skin a button to it later on. And don't forget that we can use the added edge flow to smooth out the topology even more. I'm gonna grab the border edges, I'm just gonna extrude them all out together. And this will just be faster than laying down every single quad with the quad draw tool. Again, I'm working on the shading, so I'm gonna select them all and put a hard edge and I can check how it looks. Putting another loop, I'm gonna push this loop inwards. This is to break the silhouette a bit more. Check for any hard edges that shouldn't be there and just make them soft. That's it for this part. Now we have a pretty good base for our low poly. In the next part, we're gonna refine this low poly and we're gonna start working on the UVs. So yeah, that's it. See you in the next part.